Good morning, Sawabona. Chuyamara. Konnichiwa. Namaste. Well, welcome to Assembly, and yep, I was actually listening to a bit of Bob Marley there. I was also reading a book about this man, Nelson Mandela, and a bit of a connection there. Bob Marley, Nelson Mandela, thinking of people like Martin Luther King, Archbishop Desmond Tutu, Barack Obama, Venus Williams, the tennis player, Thierry Henry, the football player. Lots and lots of people are springing to mind. See if you can figure out what the connection is. Now, today's assembly, we have shout outs. We've got a couple of jokes, not too many, but we've got a few jokes. I'll see if I can come up with some as well. Some more photos of Sports Day and a song. And yeah, that's kind of about it. Oh, there will also be a video. And in that video, there will be people that you know, but they have a very, very important message. So, stay tuned. Let's see what's going to happen in today's assembly. Okay, so we're on to Joke Corner. Now, I've had jokes from two people, but I've also got some of my own jokes because last week I had some reports that the joke about the seagull being a bagel was quite good. Actually, that came from my big sister. So I've got a few jokes of my own, but I've also got some jokes from the kids. So the first one comes in from Finn McIntosh in Primary 6, and he says, why did the golfer wear two pairs of trousers? In case he got a hole in one. And then Zach Hay, who Zach has been brilliant with these jokes, none about Mr. Silver this week, but he said, why did the music teacher need a ladder to reach the high note? What is the capital of Washington? W, of course. What holds the sun up in the sky? Sunbeams. Very good, Zach. Excellent. Okay, here's one of mine. Two hedgehogs are in the middle of the road and they're by a zebra crossing. One says to the other, don't cross here! Why not, says the first one. Look what's happened to the zebra, said the other. Oh, brilliant. Another one. When does it rain money? When there's a change in the weather. Oh, brilliant. A boy asks his father, Dad, are bugs good to eat? That's disgusting. Don't talk about things like that over dinner, the dad replies. After dinner, the father asks, now, son, what did you want to ask me? Oh, nothing, the boy said. There was just a big bug in your soup. It's gone now. So, that is Joke Corner for today. So, has anyone figured out the connection yet between Bob Marley and Nelson Mandela, Barack Obama, Bishop Desmond Tutu, Venus Williams, Thierry Henry. Has anyone figured out the connection between them? Okay. That's absolutely right. Every single one of them have skin of colour. And because of that, they have sometimes had quite a difficult life. I'm going to tell you a wee story about why Black Lives Matter.
Here we have some really, really famous black people here. We've got ex-president of the United States, Barack Obama. We have Meghan Markle, who, of course, is part of the royal family. We also have John Boyega, who is an actor who is in Star Wars. We also have Coco Gauff, who was only 15 when she beat Venus Williams in a tennis match. And then we have one of our Radio 1 DJs right there in the middle. So all these people are very, very, very famous. But all of these people have been subject at some point in their life to a thing called racism. So what is racism? Well, racism is when words or actions are used to discriminate or disadvantage people because of their colour, culture or ethnic origin. So basically, their colour, what they believe, and where they come from.
So all the people that you have just seen in that picture, they are all very, very famous, very successful black people, be it in sport, be it politics, acting, whatever. In fact, royal family even. But at the moment, you've maybe heard about trouble that there is in the United States and riots and fights on the streets. And there's also in London, there's been demonstrations about black people's lives and how important they are. Just because they have a skin of different colour doesn't make them any less of a human being. Now, it's all come about because there was a man who, at the end of May, was stopped by the police because the police thought that he was using fake money. So they stopped him and arrested him and they held him down on the ground. And they held him down so hard on the ground that they blocked his neck. And unfortunately, the man actually died. Now, this man was black and his name was George Floyd. So, as a result of that, black, white, yellow, every colour of skin in the United States thought this is wrong. Why should a white police officer be allowed to take the life of a black man? Because black people are exactly the same as everybody else. We all bleed the same colour. We all feel the same things. We all feel the same pain. Every single thing about us is the same, except for the colour of our skin. Now, this man and all other people of colour were born with that colour of skin. They didn't have a choice in it. They were born that way. So it doesn't make them a bad person. They were just happened to be born to different people with different coloured skin. So all over the world, people are standing up for the fight against racism. Now, racism is going to be explained very, very soon in a video that we actually created in the school, because I know in Downfield we treat everyone exactly the same, irrespective of whether they're LGBT, whether their colour, whether their religion is different to ours. We are what we call a very, very inclusive school, and it makes me super proud to be part of Downfield. But I just wanted to explain a little bit about what's going on in the world and why that's happening. Because people are angry. People are upset because someone has been killed basically because of the colour of their skin. Yeah, it might have been a fake $20 note that he had, but he did not deserve to die. When you see the footage of the video, you can actually hear him saying, "I can't breathe, I can't breathe, stop, I can't breathe." And the police officer still held his knee against his throat and pinned him onto the ground. Now, the police tried to cover it up because the police obviously cannot do anything like that. However, that policeman is now facing a second degree murder charge. So there is some justice, but people around the world are absolutely furious. So I want you to watch this video now that our own kids at Downfield created about racism and what racism actually is.
When I born, I black. When I grow up, I black. When I go in the sun, I black. When I scared, I black. When I sick, I black. And when I die, I still black. A new white fellow, when you born, you pink. When you grow up, you white. When you go in the sun, you red. When you cold, you blue. And when you scared, you yellow. When you sick, you green. And you're calling me colored.
That is indeed a very, very important message. Show racism the red card. Now, every single one of us can make a difference to everybody's life. We've got the power within us. So we're now going to sing a wee song called Make a Difference. I want to hear you singing. Best singing voices. Mums, dads, grannies, any adults there too. Now's your chance to learn the song.
Some good.
So it's now time for our shout outs. Lots and lots of really, really good things been happening this week. And there's also some photos of things that happened a few weeks ago. So let's see what you've been doing this week. So we've got Josh in primary four. He's working hard there on his math sheets. And he says, I've been working hard on my math sheets from Mr. Dolan. So well done, Josh. We've also got Majik sitting there in his school uniform from school uniform day doing his online P7 quiz that we had on Teams. And Majik, he actually won the quiz that day. He tells me that there was no cheating on Google, so I believe you. So well done, Majik. Absolutely brilliant. Well done. Then we have got Zach. Now, Zach sends me stuff just about every week for Shout Outs at Assembly. Last week, he was telling us about walking his dog. This week, he's been super busy. He's been going up to Plateau, and he's actually discovered a pond full of tadpoles. And every time he goes up, he looks to see how much bigger the tadpoles have been getting. So he says, I've been going for walks to Plateau, and I've been checking on the tadpoles who are growing every day. Zach has also said that I need to do a TikTok dance at Assembly. Don't think that'll work very well. Anyway, carrying on with shout-outs. So we have Libby in P2. I've been enjoying my paddling pool in this hot weather and made a truck for my LOL dolls. So well done, Libby. We've also got from Lennon in primary six. This was a bit of work that he shared with Miss Bremner as part of his home learning tasks. So this is my poem I wrote as a home learning task, and it's all about lockdown. Life indoors, online school, can't see our friends, keep 2 metres apart, don't go to the park, only out for shopping or exercise, wash your hands, no McDonald's. You'll be glad to hear that's changed now, Lennon. So well done, really good. I love that, Lennon. We have also got Molly in P5 and Rory in P1. Molly painted stones for the Scouts, and I got a gold certificate on Study Ladder. So well done to Molly and Rory. Some of those stones are absolutely beautiful. I particularly like the one on the right-hand side with the black tree. Absolutely stunning. And we've also got Evelyn in P1 and Leighton in the nursery. We painted stones and added them to the nursery stones path. So lots of stone painting going on. Brilliant. Well done. Good job, guys. Then Chanel, she always sends me things as well. So Chanel, I built a bridge, home learning task, and went for a walk to Rotty Ferry now that lockdown has been eased. And then AJ, he said, it was my birthday on the 29th and I had a great day. I've also been music. Look out for my video coming soon. Do we have a pop star in our midst? No, I will show his video just in a little moment. I've actually got another video to show you of someone being really, really clever playing the piano, and it's Emily, who is also in P2. Absolutely beautiful piano music, so I'll share that video with you as well. Then we've got some pictures from the nursery today. We've got Harrison, who says, I've been enjoying my paddling pool. Lewis, he said, the paddling pool has been great in this hot weather. And then we have Emily, who said, I'm having my own music festival on my deck. And then Reese says, I've been going for walks in the wood with my mum and my brother. And what they also did was, they painted cones and stones and things and left them behind for other boys and girls to find and take home. So isn't that a lovely idea? Now, Sports Day, we do still have some photos that have come in from Sports Day. So the first lot of photos in the colours of the best team in town. Yes, Ben Stephen, the best team in town. We have Kieran in P6 doing lots and lots of things, and it looks like he's roped his dad into things. We've also got lots of pictures from the children's nursery as well. And unfortunately, I haven't been sent all their names. So see if you can spot yourself in the pictures. I spot somebody's big brother, Leighton, in primary five. So there. So that's our photos from what you've been doing this week and also from Sports Day. So next up, we've got AJ with his music. And then after that, we've got Emily with her music. So enjoy the next couple of videos.
Wow, what a musical bunch we've got. Well done to AJ and to Emily. Fantastic stuff. Well done. So that's assembly over for today. I hope you've enjoyed it. Quite a serious message today, but remember, just because someone has a different coloured skin doesn't make them any different to you. They still need as much love and as much care as the rest of us. So be safe, stay well, love those around you, and I'll see you next week. Bye, guys!
That's all, folks.